our continuous coverage of Odisha. Our correspondents, both Pramod and Ayushmann, are still in Odisha as 6 days have passed, but things are still very, very difficult. From the day that Cyclone Fani hit Odisha, our reporters have been camping in the state as it limps back to normalcy. Some respite for those stranded and affected by the lack of transport within the state. We understand rail services between Puri and Karak have been restored, while a few trains to multiple stations are now functional. All the trains, we understand, will be operational by the 12th of May. Union Minister Dharmendra Pradhan has said the railway work is underway and power supply is being provided in phases. 70% of the power supply has been restored in some cyclone-affected areas. Both Pramod and Ayushmann are live with us. Pramod is in Puri. Pramod, yesterday you brought us the story of how people in Puri don't have food to eat, how through the entire day of your travels you didn't notice any volunteers or anybody distributing food and water. Has that changed today or is it just as bad?
Well, strangely, it was a shock for us also, because what happened earlier was that we got information from the government claiming that food and other materials are being brought over here. But here I am at one more location at Puri, and Madhav, you could see behind me. This is just a house where four families survived, and right now they don't have anything. The interesting fact is, today morning onwards, we saw a lot of trucks carrying food items and everything, but that is also causing more trouble right now, because now what they want is a ration card. Without a ration card, you cannot get the item, and any specific location, you have to get it only from there. Nothing is simplified. So the problem is that these people are asking the question. He is from that house, actually. And imagine if ration card is not there, what he will do? Will his family once again have to starve? That's the question being asked. And I'll just ask him, yahan bhi abhi relief material mil raha hai, kaisa hai mamla bhi? Relief material mil raha hai, kaisa hai abhi?
Abhi tak bhi kuch relief material kuch mila nahi.
चावल तो बेच रहे हैं, वो क्या है
सर? चावल क्या है, बड़ा गंदी वाला चावल है।
गंदी वाला चावल मिलता है
वो जी, नहीं खाने के लिए।
खाने के लिए को पसंद नहीं है। खाने का जो खाएगा तो पैसे चावल ठीक से नहीं है, बहुत गंदा का चावल है मिलता है।
और पॉलिथीन, बारिश में जो उदा हुआ वही चावल मिला,
और पॉलिथीन नहीं मिला, को सब पका कर सब भांग भेगा जाता है, और हमको कुछ नहीं मिला था। हम ऐसे पड़ता है ऊपर ऊपर छाता पाता सब खोला, कुछ नहीं।
Well, the situation still is strong, very hard over here. The thing is that there is no power. You could see behind us. I'm just showing that house as an example for you. In that house, there were four people, there are four family. The question they are asking is that how are they going to survive? The thing is, officials had come over, but damage assessment has not been done so far. They apparently have lost everything. They just have only clothes with them. And right now, what we saw was that each family is getting a sack of rice. But here they are complaining that even the sack of rice is something that have stored during the rains and it has completely gone off and they cannot eat. Something like what we saw yesterday, same condition still prevails. Here, outside, they are getting vegetables. They are trying to survive with salvaged items. That still continues. But the situation still grim in Puri.
Well, Pramod, quick question. Have you been in touch or have you, spoken with anyone from government who's handling relief in Puri? What have they told you? And how far away are you from the city centre? Because you're in pitch darkness. So I'm trying to understand if there are other parts of Puri tonight that have electricity.
Well, I'm not 4 kilometers. I could be only 4 kilometers away from the city center. That is the Jagannath temple, that area itself. The thing is that outside the city, there is one camp, base camp, where they are bringing gas stoves, food items and everything. And apparently there is a system by which it will be sent to various locations, starting from town hall to various ration shops, which they call as dealers, actually. And they are the ones who are supposed to provide this food items to others. In between, this material is not properly checked. When it comes to the dealers and when they get it from the dealers, that is where the issue occurs, but because the people are very much in a hurry to get the actual sack of rice first, and once they get the sack of rice, they take it to their home, and that is where they have the trouble, because once they open it up, many claim that that's spoiled rice and they cannot have it. Otherwise, this is the situation that's prevailing in Puri.
Let me also cut across very quickly to Ayushmann, who joins us out of Bhubaneswar. Ayushmann, could you give us an update right now? And I know you've been speaking with the state government, but the picture that Pramod is painting for us is very bad. Is the state government aware of how bad it is so close to them? And what are their solutions right now?
Yeah. Well, the situation in Bhubaneswar is not very much different from what it is in Puri. Here also today morning we reported as to how the people are struggling to get water and to get even those 2,500 which is being given to them from the government authorities. They have to stand in queues for they start about at about 3 o'clock in the morning, and only after 10 to 12 or about in the afternoon they get to receive that amount of 2,500 rupees. The dealers give them this rice, though in Bhubaneswar the people said that the rice quality that they are getting is good. The officials maintain that whatever people are saying that the rice quality is not good, they say that it is not there. They are fully aware of the fact that they are providing the relief material, and that is why they are providing to the best of abilities that they have. I am being joined by a few of the local residents of Bhubaneswar. We'll talk to them as to what are they their problems and what are they facing right now. Apno eti kedin helani eti achanti kon problem hochi eti
ga 5 bochala rahiloni eti ga batya porotaru pani ra samasya bahut bada ga
pani samasya
acha pani na sarkar am paku pathouchi na tanker karuchi kichi nai ame ga jibu mahanadi etu 8 km ga 8 km mahanadi gote stri loku ku ladies loku ku pachhare bose ga ame jibu seti puni se jhara souchu jibo kemiti aga jodi rajdhani ra avastha emiti aga puri re kon loku pauthi pani.
He's saying water situation is worse here. They have to travel to 8 kilometers to go to Mahanadi. From there, they fetch waters. कौन काम करुँछन्ती? कौन problem होची?
मु जिओ रे काम करुँछी. हमारा problem रोची, communication रा problem रोची. हमारा net भी आसुनाई, टावा network आसुनाई. Plus हमें कहीं तो communication भी करी पानू. बहुत गुले टावर भांगी है ची. सेडा restoration है ही
जी. अभी तक रिलीफ नहीं मिला है. गवर्नमेंट सिर्फ जिसका राशन कार्ड है उनको सिर्फ रिलीफ देता है, तो हम लोग को क्या होगा? हम क्या करें? खाने घर में खाने के लिए कुछ नहीं है.
आप सर बता रहे थे कि काफी समस्या है, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी क्या हो रहा है?
इलेक्ट्रिसिटी का करीबन 7 दिन से हम लोग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी का प्रॉब्लम फेस कर रहे हैं. हर साल उड़ीसा के लिए साइक्लोन आ रहा है, जैसे कि 99 से लेकर अभी तक साइक्लोन ही आ रहा है. तो साइक्लोन के टाइम का जो स्ट्रेंथ रहता है इलेक्ट्रिक पोल का, हर साल तो एक 100 मीटर से.
दीज आर दी प्रॉब्लम्स विद दिस, द कनेक्टिविटी, वाटर एंड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी आर दी मेन प्रॉब्लम्स राइट नाउ इन भुवनेश्वर इटसेल्फ. यू कैन इमेजिन अबाउट द कंडीशन इन पुरी.
आयुष्मान एंड प्रमोद, आई मस्ट थैंक यू फॉर ऑल ऑफ द हार्ड वर्क that you're putting in, the both of you tracking this rebuilding process, especially in the scorching summer of Orissa. Visuals that both of them have brought us are of people lining up to collect their ration. There's no food right now, there's no water, there's barely any electricity, and you can see live visuals of both Pramod and Ayushmann in Bhubaneswar and Puri in complete darkness. Both of those cities plunged in darkness without electricity, and in a lot of places not enough connectivity on the phones as well. Remember, I'm just going to put this up on your screen. Orissa needs help. If you can go to either Goonj or any of the other NGOs who'd be able to supply us the things that Orissa needs, they're available on the websites. Take a look at it. Or if you want to donate money, donate to the Chief Minister's Relief Fund or the Prime Minister's Relief Fund for Orissa. Orissa needs our help somehow. For some reason this time, while as a nation we've always donated whenever there's been a disaster, this time somehow we're told that there's been no reaction from the country. I appeal to you to find out what you can do, find out how you can help, and reach out to the people of Odisha. We're going to take a quick break here. We'll come back with more news and updates. Stay with us.